it going? Today we're going to explore the topic whether or not the Father, Son, and Spirit each in the Gospels affirm the deity of Jesus Christ. And we're going to show that they do. The first place I want to go is I want to deal with the Son. So Jesus was challenged by the Pharisees one time when his disciples were breaking the heads of grain off and eating them on a Sabbath day. And Jesus responded to them and he said, "The Son of Man is Lord, even of the Sabbath." Now that's a huge claim, and many people miss what it actually is saying. If you go back to Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 2, Moses tells the people of Israel in the Old Testament, he says, "You shall not add to the word which I am commanding you, nor take away from it, so that you may keep the commandments of the Lord your God." I want you to notice the commandments, including the Sabbath, are God's commandments. Nobody can lay claim to those. The only person who can be Lord of the Sabbath is God. Jesus is claiming deity. We'll go one more place. You know that the paralyzed man, they broke up the roof of somebody's house where Jesus was preaching. This is in Mark chapter 2 as well. And they let him through the roof. And where we expect Jesus to heal the man, the first thing he says is, "Son, your sins are forgiven." And immediately the Pharisees said to themselves, "He is blaspheming. Who can forgive sins except God alone?" Now they were right. If you look at David in the Old Testament after he sinned with Bathsheba, killing off her husband Uriah, when he repents in Psalm 51, he says, "Against you and you alone have I sinned, God." And he's right in the sense that it doesn't matter if you make things right with another person and they forgive you. You still need the forgiveness of God. Sins are against God. So for Jesus to say this, what he's really saying is, the sins that you've committed against God, I am forgiving those sins. That's what Jesus is saying, and that's why the Pharisees got upset. Jesus didn't correct the Pharisees and say, "Oh no, I didn't mean it like that." He actually said in verse 10 of Mark chapter 2, "The Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." He did not say, "I have authority on earth to pronounce God's forgiveness on people." He said, "I have authority on earth to forgive the sins that are against God himself." Jesus is claiming deity, right? Let's move on to the Holy Spirit. In Isaiah 61 and other places in the Old Testament, specifically in Isaiah 51 or 61, Isaiah shows that the Spirit of the Lord will empower the Messiah to do the works of God miraculously and to liberate people. When Jesus shows up in Luke chapter 4 into the temple, he reads from the scroll and he reads this part. And he says, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set free those who are oppressed, to proclaim the favorable year of the Lord." And then he said, "Today these words are fulfilled in your ears." He was saying, "I am that Messiah that the Lord God will anoint with his Spirit to do these things." What I need to point out here is that there are some things that Jesus did. For example, when he calmed the storm and said, "Peace be still," that seems to be Jesus acting out of his own deity, his own power to make that happen. But there are very clearly other places here where Jesus does not heal by his own power, but he is directed by God the Father so that the Spirit of God will move through him to do the healing. You see that clearly where the Pharisees accused him of being filled with the devil in order to cast out demons. And Jesus didn't say, no, I'm doing it. He said, "You're blaspheming against the Holy Spirit." What he's saying is, it is the Spirit moving through me that is casting these demons out. And that's important to understand. So, how does the Holy Spirit affirm Jesus' claim to deity? Jesus claiming deity is either right or it's wrong. For the Holy Spirit to have empowered Jesus throughout his entire ministry, where Jesus has intermittently continued to make claims to deity, shows that the Holy Spirit affirms the deity of Christ. We don't have the Holy Spirit verbalizing this in our New Testament or even in the Gospels, but the fact that he stays with Jesus and continues to, on God's Messiah, produce this effective healing and exorcism of demons shows that he is behind the claims of Christ. Well, what about God the Father? God the Father also affirms the deity of Christ and Christ's claims to deity. It's important to understand that God the Father is conscious of everything Jesus is saying. Jesus has claimed deity throughout the gospel. In the end, after Jesus has been raised from the dead in Acts chapter 2, verse 32, Peter, speaking to the Jews who assisted in the crucifixion, he said, "It is this Jesus whom God raised up." That's important. Professor Jean has a really good quote on page 193 of his book titled Biblical Theology. And he says this: after his crucifixion and death, we realize that Jesus' resurrection was God the Father's grant to his Son, who was obedient unto his death. So what this professor is trying to show us is that it was not Jesus raising himself, it was the Father raising Jesus, just as you have here in the words of Peter. This is important because Jesus was obedient unto death. The claims of him saying that he's deity and what he said and did were true claims. The fact that God raises Jesus from the dead is God's grant to his Son. It is God affirming that everything the Son ever did and said is justifiable, and he vindicates it by his resurrection. So you have here the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit all affirming the deity of Jesus Christ in our Gospels.